Now in this video, we'll start discussing about the ideal vapor compression cycle. In the previous videos, we looked at the air refrigeration cycles in which the working fluid was air. But in this, we'll be using some vapors of gas. Now that gas could be, you know, ammonia. That gas could be, you can say, any gas you can have. You can have CO2 also. Okay. So any gas and its vapor. It'll be compressing those vapors to create the cooling effect or the refrigeration effect. The schematic stays the same. You have a compressor, you have a condenser, you have an expansion valve, and you have an evaporator. Now, in compressor, you have some work input. In condenser, you have some heat rejection, expansion valve, nothing happens, and this has some heat absorption. Okay, if you look at the TS and the pH plot for the ideal compression cycle, it is always assumed that the vapor enters the compressor after the evaporator at saturated condition. So you can see it is on the saturated vapor line, and also in the pH plot, this is the point at which the vapors enter the compressor, that is at the saturation point or the saturation condition. After compression, the vapors attain a superheated state at 2. Okay, so this shows you have an isentropic compression. And this shows that upon compression, there is an increment in the heat value, that is the enthalpy has gone up. Now, from 2 to 3, you are going through condenser. So you lose some heat to the surroundings. So this is Q out. Okay, and this is evident from this diagram also, that your enthalpy drops from H2 to H3. Okay, so you lost some heat, but at constant pressure. Okay, now from 3 to 4, that is you go through the expansion valve. Now we assume that during this expansion valve, the enthalpy remains the same. The enthalpy remains the same, but there is an increase in the entropy because the expansion is taking place. Okay, so this is S3 and this is S4, but the enthalpy is same. Now from 4 to 1, you have to go through evaporator, so there will be some heat input. So 4 to 1 is Q in, or it is also known as the refrigeration effect. And this is the RE, and you can see that your enthalpy increases from H4 to H1. So this is the ideal vapor compression cycle. Now let's analyze it for work input and the COP of the cycle. So if you find out the work input per unit mass, okay, let's take the enthalpy values only because they are easiest to take. You have H2 minus H1, this much is the energy input in the compression cycle. So you'll have H2 minus H1 kilojoule per kg. Okay, now the refrigeration effect, because we just need two things for COP, we need the work input and we need the refrigeration effect only. So the refrigeration effect is equal to the difference in these two enthalpies. So you'll have H1 minus H4 kilojoule per kg. Okay, and the COP of the cycle of the ideal vapor compression cycle, this is equal to again refrigeration effect, which is H1 minus H4 by the work input. So this will give you the COP of the ideal vapor compression cycle. Okay,
Now this is all that we have to cover in this video. This video was aimed to give you an introduction about the ideal vapor compression cycle and the processes linked to it and how to find out the COP. Now in the next video we look at the actual vapor compression cycle, where you will have deviations in the isentropic compression and these isenthalpic expansion. So let's now go to the next video and talk about the actual vapor compression cycle.